Yeah, everybody put their tongue in.
Dude, we've all been drinking out of these Faygo bottles.
Gonna just put my tip in.
At least that has alcohol in it.
Wow, that's really good.
Hey, Faygo is clears all wounds.
Well, nothing can live in there.
Pour some Faygo in that wound.
I'm drawing a picture of Crunky Moe.
Yeah, well,
he is the character played by old Willy in Apes of Poppin'. He's half crow and half monkey.
Crow monkey, that's fun.
Crunky Moe.
So are we going to have to depose the brutal Emperor Nannerpants in this campaign?
We'll see.
Nannerpants
to bloody.
God, I just want all gorillas to have funny names.
Oh, yeah, that's a gibbon.
I would be the one.
It's a gibbon.
It's a gibbon.
All right, guys, this is party round. The party round.
Steven, and I'll be playing Jetlin Boxwell.
I'm Matt, and I'm playing Carl Seven.
I'm Mark, and I'm the DM.
Yay! Yeah.
Let's party roll.
Let's party roll.
Hi, everyone. I'm Matt. I like to edit the podcast a lot.
Hey, Matt.
Hey, everybody.
Calm down, bro.
I'm Dusty. Sorry. I'm the wacky one.
I'm Steven, everybody, and I'm...
That's my interpretation of you, Steven. Ha-ha! Last time on the party roll, not a whole lot happened. You guys kind of reviewed. You had some conversation. You found out that the... urethra of the island was backing up.
Oh no.
The magic was going back into the testes. So to speak.
That magic bladder is going to fill up with the bad magic.
The bad juju up in you. So, what is. What does Steven do?
Nothing. Fucking quit looking at me.
Yeah, don't look over there.
Look at your pages or whatever.
This is between us.
I don't have anything written down. This is all blank. I don't know how to read.
Let's look at Steven real quick, everybody.
Everybody go ahead and just.
Everybody look at him.
Party roll?
Let's party roll.
Let's
see if I give you guys a better chance this time.
Do it. Nat 20,
motherfuckers.
Two times in a row? What the shit? It's like you don't even want us to party.
I rolled a nat 1, just like Steven did last time. I got a 13 this time.
God damn it, 18. Can I at least like go to the lobby of the party?
I got a 2.
You
know about the party.
You are currently in line to get into the party.
Hell yeah.
You can come inside and watch me have a drink.
God damn it. Am I just in line to get a drink?
Or
but the bartender's really rude and won't... Well, I'm just standing there.
You're
trying
at
to
the
get
bar and he just keeps... Hey,
he's ignoring me. God damn it. I hate that shit.
But he served the guy next to you who just came up and you've been there like 5 minutes.
That describes my age from 21 to 27.
To now.
Yeah. I've gotten better. I pretty much just like give him like the dead beardy stare.
That's
and
what it is. You know,
it's
eye contact.
Yeah.
Like if you look straight at them, they will serve
I
you.
I find that ball contact works better.
Mostly so you'll go away.
Just put those balls up on there and they're like, hey, that's not sanitary. You can't do that.
Yeah.
I'll take a drink now. Thank you. Last time on the party roll.
I just got really scared of microphones. Okay, so last time on the party roll, yeah.
Guys, we're on a podcast.
Oh my god. You guys
are... Other people hear this? Guys... Oh god damn.
Hey, Jeremy.
Jeremy, get out of here.
What's up, old Shrimpy Jar Jar?
Are we really recording right now?
Like, I took a couple sigs of beer.
Rickety Shrimp.
Sigs of beer, and apparently I became insta-drunk. All right. So yeah, you guys were on a... Well, you're on the way back home, or back to the city of Talanthus to report your findings to the one and only king. But little does he know that apparently you've made a pact to depose him with violence.
If needed.
But no one knows that but us, pretty much.
Yeah,
it's
well,
be needed.
We're keeping it super secret.
We're going to cut his nuts
You just,
off.
Like... When Airdrie's not looking, you guys are just high-fiving each other constantly.
Sharpening blades. Yeah.
It's going to be awesome.
It's going to be so fucking cool. Now we're going to be the ones that sit in chairs backwards.
We'll keep his head in our backpack.
It's going to be like Mr. Johnson.
So you're on the way. Airdrie has just finished asking you, you know, about things, and you reveal to him discreetly that you did, in fact, encounter his father among the descendants.
But he seemed pleased with
he kind of closed his eyes and
thanks, I guess.
Like, you could tell it was a very conflicted feeling that he was having as he hat coughed his influenza lungs out.
It's really thinking hard.
So his attention now turns to the tied up person behind you. He says,
"Don't look at her."
Now I know I know what you told the guard captain, but who is this really?
My best friend, Raimi.
Yeah. Why? I know I've seen how your party treats their supposed friends, but why is she tied up?
What's that supposed to mean? We always treat you good.
Yeah, pull out the photos of all of
you. You use him as an oar.
Wait, who's talking right now?
Hey.
This is Airdrie.
Airdrie.
We didn't all use you.
Remember, Airdrie has my voice because I was really lazy when I made him. Yeah. And now it's awkward when I'm him because my voice doesn't change.
Yeah. Wait, are you... Did he say that?
Yeah, that was Airdrie that said that whole speech.
Yeah. Airdrie, don't try and act like we're not
just
best
me,
friends.
But actually expressing how displeased I am with all of you. That's who Airdrie is.
Okay. Not internalizing it like usual. Got it. Okay, guys, this is now Mark talking.
So yeah, who is this?
Mark
this
is asking
woman you have tied up.
Look, Airdrie, don't make it awkward, okay?
I feel like by saying that, you are in fact making it more awkward.
I don't want to talk about it.
See, that's what I mean by awkward.
Guys, can you help me out here?
Yeah, man.
Facebook status. Hey, God, everybody just needs to leave me alone right now, okay?
Don't look at her.
It's complicated.
Don't look back at Cupcake or all the blood on Cupcake or the woman draped across Cupcake.
Look at all these great rocks I found in the
also,
dirt when we were back there. You can have this one.
Danielle Kay, the one that we walked through that was by the lake.
But you have to give it back.
Yes. Where is she?
That's her. That's her on the back of the horse.
That's not her.
That's her. I use my deception.
Roll for this.
I rolled a nat 20 plus 7 is 27.
Oh, fucking shit.
I still need a good explanation for how you're going to explain how this is somehow her.
We were in out into the woods and she hit her head.
Do you know a spell of...
Fumbles.
Oh, yeah.
Gets his disguise kit.
Yeah, Fumbles.
And he's going to sneak back there while you guys are talking and disguise her up to look like Danielle Kay, by which, I mean, she's going to have a Groucho
Marx
glasses on.
This is where Lord Barrington came to life.
Explain why he's a bear that can talk. Oh, no, he can't talk. He can just fumble his way around. And
it'd be 22 if I did it with sleight of hand.
Okay.
He puts a mop on her head.
She's okay.
Was Danielle Kay blonde? I don't remember. Anyway, she is now.
Yeah, fine, whatever.
Okay, assuming that's Danielle Kay.
It is.
Definitely blonde.
Why is she tied up?
We went out into the woods and she got a little mouthy and we tied her up. That's how we do it in the swamps.
She was trying to run away and it would not be safe.
That's not the proper way to treat a councilwoman.
That's not what you should be talking about.
Honestly, if you had heard what she told us out in the woods, we're taking her back to the king to tell him what she said, and it's none of your business.
Yeah, Airdrie, you're not being a good best friend right now.
Yeah, the council won't matter for long.
What?
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 Yeah, Airdrie.
Huh?
Did you hear that? No, you didn't, because your ears are dumb.
Your ears are all full of penises, so you don't know.
I thought we
did
were
I like, get him good, Buria?
Yeah, you got some good ones.
High five.
But seriously, Daniel K, she said some stuff in the woods. We're taking her back to the king so he can deal with her and the way he sees fit when we tell him what she said in the
woods.
Just
look at that disguise I put on her. It looks exactly like Daniel K. How can you mistake her for anybody?
Now, it seems like you're all suddenly fiercely loyal. The last time I talked to you, you seemed to be waiting.
What we saw out in the woods swayed us in the other direction.
And now okay. We really need to see the king in person, in because private.
That's odd, because...
With our weapons
I did do
us.
Some investigation of my own, and...
Hey, your dad's cool, right?
What?
He does.
Oh my gosh.
Your dad's... We could, like, smoke in the garage?
If we
can
really...
Can we, like, have a beer?
If we really talk to people like this... It'd be so fucking confusing. Just like, hey, are you guys... Don't look at that person.
Guys, that
what,
is
y'all,
what, we're
what
doing.
Are y'all talking about? Hey, man.
Well, now you know why Air Jane is so just flabbergasted.
Your dad's cool, right? Guys, what are you... The fuck are you guys talking about?
I'm trying to distract him.
Corey, don't break our role playing.
I love it. No,
well, I mean,
great.
You also got to remember this is five different people talking at the same person, all trying to be funny while trying to explain away this situation that you can't literally explain away.
And we're also all drunk on alcohol and Faygo in real life and in game.
Okay, what I meant
this
to say...
This is week 2 of Faygo, by the way. I bought a lot of Faygo.
What I meant to say was, I'm glad this is how we really okay. act in real life, as well as role playing.
Our damn japes.
Absolutely.
Too many japes.
Well, we used to be a lot more like casual until Jeremy started joking us up a lot, you know?
Jokey Germ, that's another one of his names.
Yeah. Jokey Germ, yeah.
Jokey Germ.
Just can't get rid of them.
Jokes.
You can't get the germs off is what he used to say.
Can't get the germs off.
He used to say jar them up and let them out later.
Jar them up.
Oh, God.
No, I'm cutting it.
Okay.
Maintain composure. Okay.
What's Erdrin thinking now that he's heard all this pile of nonsensical bullshit?
Okay, well,
and all are talking about Jarmy
going to say that
Shipkin is gay.
It's so red.
I took the things
red, like red fake.
Red pop.
No, we
red
lost
pop.
It. We lost it.
Okay, okay. What does Erdrin say?
I was going to say that the things you said to me back at the glade kind of sank in, and I've been doing some research myself, but if you've come around, I guess you've come around and we don't need to discuss anything further.
Let us know. Talk it out.
Yeah, man, where's your friend?
Is there a tiny stool around somewhere?
I could make a tiny stool.
I think you could stand up
beside one of it. Gross. we could stop.
Intriguing.
Is there a little place for me to rest?
You can find a rock.
A little chair or something. You can find a rock to prop your knee up on, if that's what you were going for here.
All right, Erdrin. What did you mull over that changed your way of thinking?
I've done some more research into the deaths, and...
Tell us about your research, Erdrin.
I definitely think there was foul play in Lindrick's death.
Oh, really?
I didn't see any birds.
And I...
can't finish the sentence. And I fear that the king may have been involved.
Oh, wow.
Well, that would make sense, because when we were at the Descendants village...
Like the dramatic
what?
And
revelation.
What? We didn't tell him that?
I mean, when we weren't over there at all...
What involvement do you think the king has in all of this?
From what I've uncovered, I believe that him and Lendrick may have been lovers.
Oh, that's hot.
That's...
Huh?
That's all I know, but... But he died under very suspicious circumstances. And then, immediately after that is...
Lovers
when
of what?
Council
like,
members started dropping.
Like, good food, or like... hang gliding, what do they love?
Well, we also do believe the king may not be completely on the up and up. There may be some things going on that he may not be the best guy about, but we still think we need to report to him the important information and return this potential traitor to him.
He likes sitting in chairs backwards, but he may not be so cool.
Okay, well...
What was he mad at Lindrick over?
I haven't figured that out yet.
Then why would he kill the other ones,
I'd hope
ones
that maybe
too?
You would be more disclosing of information with me, but... If that's what you want, that's what
you
want. Oh,
don't worry. If you have your own investigation, maybe you know it all.
We gave you
Airdrins
a lot of information last time, and yeah. You did come. Were forthcoming with us, but this is very.
You were very forthcoming.
But this is very important.
Always, please, always bring Bria to negotiations so he can just stand back there and mock everything they say.
Even his own team! Don't mock me! We're the team!
So disheartened.
I don't want to be team anymore.
What are you, Jeremy?
Stop Germany, man!
Getting your germs all over me.
Stop jarring up this conversation.
He's germing you around.
God damn it, I forgot what I was saying. Sorry. Anyways, my point was that I still don't fully trust Airdrin.
Is that at the side?
Yes.
Oh no, I said it to his face.
Oh, that changed things.
We don't want you to wreck Dravik.
Did you fluff your penis at him when you said that?
Like, just it rises and then falls back down.
I got.
Also, I assume it's on a hinge. That's how that works.
Honest with you here, Airman. all these back and forthings going on, and all these people getting all fighting over these different things. I just my brain's. I don't know who to trust anymore, fella.
Well, that's understandable.
But so, I know.
I don't like keeping secrets. It's inside me like it's bottled up in there and it's just...
Like it's flowing the wrong direction?
Come,
or
like it needs jar. To come flushing out, but... I don't know who I can share these
like
things with.
Like a wad of black goo lodged deep down in your lungs and slowly...
Airdrin, can growing. I share... my load of secrets with you or not.
Please release them everywhere.
I was going to say, trust is kind of rare right now, but I do know who's going to pay our paycheck. So that's who, as of right now, I'm going to confide in.
You have a point? As of this time, I too still owe my fealty to the king. So
I don't worry.
We will all do as good
money.
Subjects do. Let the chips fall where they may.
You got some chips?
Airdrin, friend.
Stop bogarting
the chips. Yeah, buddy.
Level with me. Do you know anything?
I lift Fritz up some so he can be level.
Oh, there. Right at level.
He sits on your knee. We're in the cart, remember? You know, he's sitting on your knee.
Now that we're on the level, eye to eye, you
please,
would say.
Please hurry up, my arms are very weak.
No, you made it less dramatic. All right. Airdrin, have you heard anything about the island being alive?
Only the stories.
Stop shaking.
The king disapproves of such old legends being passed around, but of course, it's one of those things that gets around.
Airdrin, come here.
He leads in a little closer.
Come closer.
Yes.
I've been sent on a secret mission from the druids.
Oh!
Get closer. Come here.
Yeah.
I dropped you a little bit.
Back up. Okay. I need to find out. Come here. Okay, a little closer.
Yeah.
I need to find out. What's happening to this island?
Okay.
Something's not happening.
Can I lean back now?
No. Shh, shh, shh. I put my baby finger next to his lips. All right, Airdrin. I felt a great force die in this forest, along with an elemental. Do you understand?
I don't understand.
Actually... You may need to see what we're about to pass.
Airdrin, come here. Come here.
Yeah?
Let's go do that.
Okay.
Can I put you down now?
All right, put me down.
He just starts cracking and like slides. when you finally get to the ground, it sounds like a belt busting off a car, and my arm just goes limp. Oh, damn.
Oh, man, I knew I should have drank that milk a couple hundred years ago.
You ride for another good half an hour or so until over the edge of the hill, you see what a large expanse of browning trees, like leaves falling.
This makes me sad.
These trees suck.
It is not autumn.
Man, this view is a traffic.
What are you singing over there?
Travesty.
California?
And Airdrin says to you,
Airdrin, what happened to Fern Gully? What will we chew on without
this leaves? Is the Illuminance Glade.
The who? Alu? What?
Well, that's where we were.
The Illuminati.
Hey, what happened here? Where it was you, all nice
the water
and
place.
Where we dispatched a guardian.
Glaven.
Now, oops. Wait. You mentioned something about another guardian?
Okay.
He whoops. Got mad at us.
Is this the one? We were there with the water guardian.
Water guardian is this one.
Right.
It kicked its ass.
Okay.
Don't be proud of that, apparently.
Wait, yeah. That was bad.
All right, Airdrin. From my knowledge of what's been going on,
yes,
it turns out, somehow, I don't know how, but all of the guardians are dying. Somehow. Somehow.
We killed one.
Right.
I was there.
Yes.
Some cool dudes may have killed one.
It was very unfortunate.
Well, he's saying we know how this one died, but right. The other ones are also dying.
Did
we
you
don't know
kill
how-
another?
I didn't.
Now, Airdrin.
Can't pin it on me.
They're dying. Something's killing them, and we don't know exactly what's going to happen now that they're dead.
Well, on that note, I have discovered something else that I didn't quite piece it together until just now.
That you love Fritz.
Oh, here we go again.
He slowly slides a crumpled piece of paper towards Fritz.
Slowly slides his hand.
Slides it on what?
Fritz.
I was going to say he gave you his phone number.
Pick up your love notes, Fritz.
He lays on the ground and slides it on the ground.
It's dirty now. The undying flame in the Temple of the Sun is shining almost twice as bright now.
Oh my God. Is it eating the guardians?
Hmm.
Is that how it gets so big?
The energy of the island is not being properly balanced, and that flame is pulling more as these guardians no longer have control of their regions.
Bingo.
And I cough up black goo everywhere.
That's how my cousin Dumbles got so fat, because he ate two of his kids. They had too much goat in them, he said, so he went ahead and ate them.
When I was young, my father told me stories of that he had learned from the natives of the island.
All right, hold on. Go on.
He said that, indeed, the island was once a living creature. A great shaper of lands.
Mm-hmm.
They called it the Ontonac.
Worms, yes, yes.
Ontonac. Okay. How do you spell that? I'll figure it out.
All right. I'll tell you later. Privately. The...
Tell me later. Got it.
In order to however, this one moved in discordance with the other shapers and had to be stopped, so it was chained.
Got it.
At the spots of its chains, the great flames leapt up, and from them, great fonts of life babbled, and that's why living things are able to thrive on this island that otherwise would be barren rock.
Well, shit.
Mm-hmm.
We probably shouldn't have killed those two. I mean, that one guardian, and witnessed the other one die.
'Tis but a story, but, well... folklore tends to have at least some kernel of truth, and strange things have been happening.
Airdrin, thank you for your candor.
That tale is quite Travic.
No, that fuck it. I'm out.
Podcast. Yep, yep. Bye, guys. Hey, I'm punning here.
Man, I almost just quit the podcast.
Should we tell him?
Yes, Steven, that was terrible.
Right. About the Gnolls and the guy.
Matt needs to finish chugging a Faygo now.
is your punishment.
I know your dad's name.
There.
Thank you.
I love your like your so, weird hits.
He told us his dad's name.
Well, I tried to bring it up three times now. And he never responds, so.
He was
He's embarrassed,
a leader
Matt.
There where we went.
That's what I'd feared. He disappeared many years ago. And the official story was he'd been killed in action.
Also, this isn't Danielle Kay. This is Raimi. I just put a mop on her head. Danielle Kay's
Ta-da!
You really had me fooled. I don't know who that is, but what happened to Danielle Kay?
She's dead.
Oh, shit.
You see, what done happened was one damn undead came out through the woods.
I don't want to think about it. Don't talk about it.
Done what stabbed her in the heart with the spur.
Gentlemen, you're upsetting fumbles. Would you please?
And that's who this is.
What?
That's who you have tied.
Yes.
Well, it wasn't technically her doing.
She had the smoke Pokeball.
What?
In her heart.
Got these orbs?
She had this Smokeball.
I pull out mine.
Oh, damn it, Dusty. I was just about to make that joke.
My sweet dexterity orb to show to them.
Oh, you showed those to me.
Well, apparently they are our souls.
That would make sense.
And one she caught had some kind of...
He pulls out a little notebook and scribbles something down. It's like that goes... Right along with what I found out. Okay, yeah, keep going.
I scribble more.
Anyway, it had like an evil soul, and the hyena cat dog creatures were trying to eat her, and a robot threw it at her, and she like broke it and got an evil soul in her, and then stabberated Danielle.
If I'm understanding, which let's be honest, I'm not.
Okay.
But if I'm understanding.
You were always a little slow on the uptake.
The undead that was killing council members is now inside of this living woman?
Yar.
Yar. That appears to be the case, yes.
Keep up with the group, Erdrin.
Hey man, they invented No Child Left Behind for a reason.
Kia. One child left behind.
One child left behind.
Jeb!
Oh, Jeb. Poor Faygo out for falling Jeb.
This Faygo's for you, Jeb.
Okay, so he now knows that Danielle Kay is dead.
Right.
That is not Danielle Kay.
Right.
That she's possessed by the demon.
Uh-huh.
That we did find the descendants' village.
Yes.
And that we are now going back to the king.
Right. Furthermore.
And that Jeb is a mess.
The king is a mess. Well, my friend Airdrain. It seems that if the king was able to send an assassin to the descendants' village, then he must have already known its location, would he not?
What?
Or is he in control of these assassins at all?
I didn't find that. All I know is it started after that, and the first was actually, if you remember, was actually in the body of Lendrick.
Right. His lover.
Indeed.
Why would he kill his own...
A small aside. You guys found out Corey wasn't there, but you guys found out... The name of the creature.
The Revenant.
The Revenant.
Good movie.
There's Revenant.
The Revenant. Oh. We also found out that this is also an aside, and Jedwin's not saying this, that the Revenant is actually wants to kill the king.
It's true.
Which is supposed to feed into our plan of taking Raimi back to the king. Maybe she'll do our dirty work for us.
I didn't even know that part.
Corey.
You guys didn't tell me shit.
Oh, we tell you now.
Yeah, so
we
she
told
is
Corey.
Possessed by the Revenant. Hopefully, who is after the king. We take her back. Maybe she does our dirty work. Maybe she gets sacked. She dies in the process. That's really sad and everything.
That is like the most important thing you could have told me.
We forgot except for Steven, though.
A high five,
I'm pretty
Fritz.
Sure that I didn't remember to tell you this whenever I was talking to you about this at work the other day.
Oh, yeah.
You see, you did not remember? Or you did remember?
Yeah, I didn't remember to tell him that.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry, do we want to impart this information to
Sorry, me and Matt
Airdrin
didn't tell you
yet.
That one day we
No,
worked with you.
We don't. I don't trust Airdrin. I have a feeling that he will betray us.
Anyway, yeah, so she has that crazy council people killing thing in her.
See, I don't even think we should have told him that much.
Too late. Sorry.
That's quite a lot. That's... Wow. Okay.
We believe it's under control now, so don't worry about that.
But I'm confused.
We gave her some Tylenol PM. She should be pretty tired.
Let's so tuckered out.
Okay, let's head to the kingdom now.
Yeah. Oh, okay, let's head on right into that there kingdom, eh?
All right. Yeah.
My name's Dave Ryder.
Is there a way that... Does he know how to get to that flame?
He doesn't know we know he knows how to get to that flame. What? We know
that flame is right in the middle of the
we
temple.
We know how.
Right.
Out in the open.
But we didn't get to go underneath to where like the flame actually was.
Hmm. Does he know that we know we don't know how
Fumbles
to get down
might
there?
Be able to
Maybe
find
he'll
a way.
Tell us.
Well.
Yeah,
well.
I don't know.
Okay. So I say we head back, keep heading back to the kingdom.
All right. You guys head back. You've been going for a few days now. Okay. You stop and sleep. I haven't been including that because sleeping gets boring.
Yeah, why is D&D so all about, hey,
D&D's
take a nap.
D&D's all about the travel. It's like, all right, let me roll to see if there are encounters on the road because we need to stall this even more. No, I don't do that shit. So anyway, yeah, you guys, it's another, I think, 2 days from the glade to the city.
Man, what a crazy 2 days, huh, there, fellas.
Quite traveling we have been done, yes?
I learned quite a lot in my travels. Maybe I will tell it to you one day. Maybe not.
Did I say anything over those 2 days? I don't remember either one of them.
I don't remember a single thing.
Remember that one time Jedwin did not talk for 2 whole days? That
just
was weird.
Just riding behind you, just
Your
staring
Your miss old shrimpy Jar Jar
for...
that we met along our way.
He was the best.
Yeah, yep. Guys. It's been a fucking crazy 2 days.
Jeremy, you're so cool. Do you remember when Jeremy drank sodas all the whole 2 days?
Yeah, he sure did love soda.
It's like, Jeremy, there's only 3 servings in that Faygo. Stop drinking so fast.
3 whole servings of Faygo. Oh, God. All right, yeah, you reach the city gates. The town appears even more majestic than you remember. It's almost blinding now how bright and magnificent it seems.
It hurts my eyes.
You in particular, and I'm going to even say probably Jedwin a little bit, feel the magic has grown much stronger here since you left.
Can you feel the magic tonight?
Yeah, I really can right now, actually. It feels much stronger since we left.
You feel like this is the... You are probably standing above the bladder.
Probably
so to speak.
Standing
is,
above
the backup.
Blast.
You are at the Dusty, what's the name for this?
Oh, the urethral semen discharge into the bladder castle.
Yeah. Oh, well, I thought. Yes. No, I thought. What? I thought you needed some horrific medical term for that.
Oh yeah, no, that they just call that a semen fuck up.
We are at the urethral blockage
right there.
That is a very technical
Gotta
term.
Gotta see shanty.
Everything here is even more glowy.
All right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's, yeah.
We would like to go make communications with the king. There's a word for that, but I done forgot it. Make talk jaw it. I don't know.
I imagine it'll
like
be...
for real. I don't remember what the word is.
I look around for Ty Ty.
Yeah, where's Ty Ty?
Yeah, come on, give us that character we haven't talked to.
Damn, I was gonna pull that out, but now you guys ruined it.
I hold my axe up.
Oh boy!
Where's that
Ty Ty?
I've got to finish your haircut, Ty Ty.
I'm sorry, I ruined it, Mark. I didn't know you were gonna bring that back,
Matt.
Quit fucking apologizing. You've already fucked up everything.
God damn it,
fucking Matt.
I almost left because of you.
As you guys enter the gate, you see...
Why running, are you here and Jeremy is not?
You, a young blonde Jeremy boy does. Who you all recognize.
Bieber.
He Yay! Has...
The city is so dravistic.
He has a haircut that looks as if he tried to cut it himself with some kind of hatchet.
Oh my goodness.
Well, he tried to cut his hair with a hatchet? That's so cute.
No, somebody else tried to cut his hair.
I say, your hair looks so cute.
Thanks, buddy. I was kind of scared after you tried to murder me last time when I led you guys up to the castle, but I don't know. I think you guys are pretty cool.
It was just the haircut.
It's a spin haircut. Goodbye.
Do you want me to finish?
Please don't do that. I want to live.
Okay.
I think he wants to die.
Oh, hey, it's Mia. Hey. Would you like Mia to give you the finishing haircut? She's transporting.
Sorry, I would try to give you my stick again.
I don't understand out of game banter.
I threw it in the woods. And it didn't come back.
All right.
I hope it served you well.
He's too
okay,
cute.
I picked up a different stick.
I hate him so much because he's too cute.
My one upbeat character.
So I walk away because I am completely disgusted with
Where
this
you
kid.
Heading?
I'm going to go to the king.
Anyway, where's the king at? We're going to the king.
Okay, Tai-Tai, I might finish your haircut later, so just get out of here.
I hold
We're
his hand.
On official business.
All right.
We walk lockstep to... the king.
Do you pop lock and drop it?
Yeah.
Cool. It's pretty
I
cool.
actually attached him to my belt and we have a good
well,
time.
Well, this is different. I've never done this
okay.
before.
Sure. That works.
Okay.
Why don't you just attach small people to your belt?
Hey, that's what I just did.
When we get to the palace, I go up to the door and I'm like, hello. Can we
go in? The guards standing on either side of the gate are just looking at you.
It's okay. I'm the king's friend.
Do you need to go in?
Oi, don't knock on the king's microphones. It's for royal recordings only.
Hey, so
king
anyway.
King likes to drop some mad sick beats. They're delicious. He eats them with every meal.
cut all of that.
Yeah, no,
so we go
it's
in
there.
Yeah, I mean it's time to go in. Erdrin kind of as you're approaching, he says, "All right, I'm gonna go ahead and take this prisoner down, I guess, to the dungeon for processing. I still don't entirely understand what's going on."
Well, I think that the king needs to see and deal with her.
Well, if this is a dangerous undead,
it's not undead.
We're
dangerous.
Up.
She's tied up.
She's not like I mean,
like
really
when she don't know.
Got
also,
after
she's
her.
Gonna,
Danielle, what? We're able to stop her.
What okay. Is she in a state where she's conscious?
I think you did. You like? Did you bound her mouth? I assumed you
don't
did, but
even know what happened.
Like
we're
that.
Not into that shit. No.
I got a 21. Shit! I dropped it.
I got a 20.
I persuaded him better than Corey did.
Oh,
so
sorry,
no,
sorry.
I persuaded him better.
I got an 18. I'm sorry.
We all tried to persuade. I got a 15.
So at the exact God same time, you all start trying to persuade him. So just everybody persuade. Go.
No, she's my best friend.
No, see, look at me. Okay.
When she tried to get Danielle K, I only didn't stop her because she was there first. But if I'd been there first, I could stop her. Wait, we're able to
okay,
tie her
you know
up.
What?
And I'm
you know
gonna...
what? Great idea, guys. Great idea. Let's do it.
I got to show her to my friend Talanthus.
Right, does you guys... he believe us now?
Yeah. He's totally sold because every time you guys try to do anything, you roll insanely well. So,
yeah. I have
brand.
A really high persuasion and deception.
Yeah, your
score.
Charisma is
insanely
like,
high.
Yeah. All right.
I might be ugly and dress like a man from the swamp, but I am quite charming.
It's true.
Classic swamp charm.
It's that swamp etiquette.
Hey, Charmy, out of my pants when his got dirty and I didn't have any pants. Charm me right out of them.
I'm wearing 4 pairs of pants. Keep charming to run off people.
Don't be Charmy 4 pants.
So, yeah, you head on in, and Yeah, Erdrin goes to inform the guards, and that's the royal trumpet.
It's a good trumpet.
And
going they're new. They're new.
He's going all Kenny G on it.
you don't freestyle a trumpet. Just plays the blues scale. it's his first day.
Okay. What? Stop playing trumpet. Like, the king gets to come out of
30 them. Minutes of us making trumpet noises.
The characters are just like, why are they still playing trumpets? Where is he?
You win! They're standing like 2 inches from your faces, just playing trumpet.
Just spit flying in
so
your face.
So it's blindingly glowing, and now they're playing trumpets at us.
I don't want to do it anymore.
Make it stop.
All right. They walk out with a dais? What did we decide this thing was called?
Litter.
Dr. Zaius?
Litter, like. I don't know. I think I called it a Cadillac chair.
Yeah, there we go.
It's a Lincoln chair.
Hi, teacher.
Acura chair.
So they walk out with the Mercedes chair and put him down.
He just keeps upgrading.
He looks radiant.
He looks dapper as fuck.
Yeah. He, you know, again, it's in his kingly robes. He has he seems to almost be glowing like a happy pregnant woman.
Or like one of those glowworm toys.
You notice that, or I don't know. Who amongst you is the most perceptive?
My perception, I do have a plus 25 on that.
What? Have you been lying to me the entire game?
You wouldn't know if I was.
That's the problem.
I do have a plus 3 on perception.
I got plus 3 as well.
I'm going for passive perception. Just things you notice.
Passive perception.
I have plus 4.
Plus 0.
I don't even know.
Well, it should be a score.
One.
I don't know but if you put it on yours or not.
You have plus 4?
Most people's passive perception is like 10.
Oh. What would that be?
My wisdom? Passive perception is 13.
Yeah, I think it is your wisdom.
Okay, so it's yeah, 13. Plus 1.
13 for me.
Okay. You guys notice he's wearing a different crown. Seems to be the original crown, but inlaid with a slightly duller, shimmery metal.
Oh, guys, no. It looks like his original crown was inlaid with some shimmering metal.
He's got the goddamn bug crown on.
Yeah, it's the
that bitch pants Erdrin gave him that bug crown.
Oh. We don't know if it's the bug crown. It's the metal. The shipment of metal.
Was the Ant Queen a guardian?
What was the name of the metal? Noondrite. Thank you.
Wait, what did we do with the ant crown? I thought you threw it in the ocean.
No, I gave it to Erdrin.
Oh, fuck. Goddamn fucking Erdrin.
Yes,
we were friends.
You were my best friend.
He extends his arms out. He says, it's about time.
Hi.
What's up, guys?
Sorry, we were on a schedule. What the fuck is happening?
I miss Mr. King. How's it going?
It's cool, man. It's cool. So what you been up to?
Not a lot.
Please tell me he's sitting backwards in his chair.
Oh, yeah. That's his
throat. We can't even see him. It's a throne.
His crown's on sideways, leaning over.
No, he kind of, like, leans backwards with his arms crossed against his throne.
God damn,
tilts his head back. What's up, guys?
Jesus. He playing hot cross buns because his hands are crossed.
Turns his crown backwards.
Okay. Hello, your Mr. Majesty. Greatest kingly king of all kings.
Let's get to the chase, guys. Did you find a descendants?
Oh.
Okay, pause, characters, pause. Are we going to tell him? I mean, are we going to tell him what we know and then double-cross him?
Let's Raimi tell him. Is squirming and... You can hear muffled screaming.
Yes, we brought back their woman, Outlander.
We have your woman!
I say we tell them, and then we'll be tell like, everything. Here's your trophy.
What is that?
It's a lady.
Do you not know what ladies look like?
You brought me a lady?
She's a descendant. That's our prisoner that we captured.
She's a very high-ranking official that we captured while we were infiltrating their camp.
I heard through the grapevine...
Well, do you like ladies?
That's what I actually call her. He's my little grapevine. I heard through the grapevine that you guys had Danielle Kay with you. I mean, it's a good idea to take her with you, but where is she?
Don't worry about
this
it.
This traitor killed her.
We put her somewhere.
Oh, that's
unfortunate.
And that's why we brought her to you, Your Majesty.
All right, I mean,
so you can deal with her yourself.
That's weird. There's a process we have for prisoners, but I mean, okay.
We don't usually do things by the books, in case you had noticed.
And I had to close a book.
That's why you get results.
That's our motto. We don't do things by the books.
We usually have a question mark on the card. Why we get results.
Yeah.
Whenever we throw parties, it always ends at ?? Because you don't know when the party's gonna go.
So she's only tied up, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Untie a prisoner so that the king may hit her with his kingly hands.
What are you doing here?
Well, because you gotta punish her for killing the people.
Roll me a charisma.
Me?
Yeah.
Hello.
5.
You feel you hear a voice in your head. What are you trying to do, little goat man?
I'm hungry.
It's very pure.
That's probably the one thing Sundus has. You're not gonna find anything in there.
Goddamn goat man. I'm the goat man.
Okay, so who talked into Fumble's head?
We don't
king
know.
Colon anus. The king.
His expression grows from happy to kind of stern. He goes,
Howard Stern?
He's kind of looking at you all. Says, again, why would you bring a prisoner into my throne room?
Oh, I didn't know that we weren't supposed to. All right,
I'm rolling for it. Let me get see my shitty charisma.
I'm going to use sleight of hand.
What are you trying to tell the king?
I'm just going to tell him it's
to untie.
It's a gift.
Raimi's knots, but not actually pull the ropes off of her, so nobody notices that she's untied.
I will also try to convince him that we brought the girl.
Nat 20.
All right.
To stealth untie her.
Reach a pinky over and start undoing the ropes with it,
and nobody's going to notice because I'm stealthy.
I rolled a 1. Plus 1 charisma is a 2. Oh.
So Raimi is untied. She still has the rope sitting on her, but she's not tied up.
All right. She bolts towards the king.
Whoa, what? I didn't know that was going to happen.
I bolt towards the king, too.
Both of you?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Shit.
You notice that guards have started to step in because he's been eyeballing all of you, and it feels wrong to him. Like, he can... He's in your brain. But fuck it. This is
Oh shit.
Oh, holy fuck.
I think we did something.
Oh, we did something, guys.
We did a thing.
So is this roll initiative?
Whoever's involved in this.
We're all here, aren't we?
In my ex.
Fuck, guys. He's like OP right now too. He's like glimmering and shimmering and stuff.
Dude,
so it's great.
His sideways like king hat looks so cool.
Got a feeling this is gonna be nasties. So I'm gonna go ahead and roll.
Well, the king's guards are all super shitty, so at least that part.
I'm not worried about
them. We haven't fought a king's guard yet.
But they all got slaughtered by other things. So.
Yeah, that was other things though.
But those other things are on our side now.
Well, we'll see what happens immediately. I have a pencil over here. Oh, okay, you got one.
18. Steven, what are you doing? You hanging back?
Don't look at me.
Okay.
Don't look at me.
All right.
I'm contemplating.
As soon as I talked about, hey, let's untie Raimi, King's like, wait a fucking minute.
He obviously
and I'm quite like, yes, I might as well just go ahead and fucking do it, because he's already like, what the fuck are you doing?
Well, I mean, Mark mentioned that he could hear into our thoughts, so.
With the king? So that was the king?
Yeah.
God damn it.
Who do you think intercepted the message from the crow?
Yeah.
Mr. Mark.
Mark was the king.
What? All right, fucking give me numbers. Daddy fuckers.
I moved my dice. Hold on.
Shit.
Carl got a 7.
Oh, I got a 7 as well. Good call.
Fritz got a 7.
What?
Carl got a 7 and Fritz got a 7.
Carl got a 7 and Fritz got a 7. They got a 7 and hey!
It's a good song, guys.
That's our new hit song. Carl and Fritz got a 7.
Oh, Rob and Evan, they don't add up to 11. But what you got 2 sevens.
Yeah, that's the one. That's the new song that we have.
Who else rolled things?
Chicken Noodle Man going down.
Did you get mine? Did you get mine?
Carl got a 7. Fritz got a 7.
Yeah.
It's a fucking song, man.
Bumble's got 16.
Bumble's got 16. Just making sure y'all knew what the song was. Glad you guys know what the song is.
Brilla?
Where's my initiative?
Okay, Jedwin?
Plus 2.
Jedwin hasn't rolled.
Jedwin doesn't know what's going on. Okay.
Shit, dogs, I got a 7.
All right.
It's a 7 table over there? 7 has 7 side?
Wait, do we all get 7s?
Yeah. Oh, 7. Everyone, 10 guys, out of 7.
Hey, that's a good sign.
That's like a crit in Final Fantasy 7.
Yeah, that every is. Character does 700.
Right, yeah, you guys just run back and forth doing 7 damage.
Hell yeah.
7, 7, 7.
Wait,
7.
What do I add to it?
Nothing.
7.
Your initiative.
Initiative.
Did you not add initiative?
Rolling initiative.
No.
To your initiative?
It should be your dexterity modifier.
Hey, Corey, do you need to drink more Faygo so you know what's going on?
I think I'm drunk. I'm Faygo drunk.
Dude, this,
oh shit!
This is ridiculous. I feel like I'm gonna have a diabetic coma on this shit.
Yeah.
This is ridiculous.
That's all right. I'm edging it out with some beer.
It's really. I switched to water.
Some nitro.
It's really bad. This Faygo is really.
No, I feel I do not like it. It's not like
it's hurting my body.
It's more sugar than I've had in probably weeks.
This is worse than the time we had Surge.
Yeah, no, like. It's worse
but
than
dude,
Surge.
The crazy thing is that the bottom of all the balls it says naturally caffeine free, but I don't know how because I feel like it's poisoning my brain.
No, I'm my brain is.
Well,
I
mean, is it made in Michigan?
It makes sense because okay. The band itself also poisons your brain.
Let's actually.
Is this
go.
Like made for Michigan municipal water?
They were trying to convince the king that.
Oh, fuck you.
Raimi was a prize for him. He didn't like it. Fumbles, unties her. She attacks. Carl attacks. Everybody else starts to attack. He intercepted the crow from me.
He did.
So does he see me as an enemy?
All he knows is that you guys were acting really weird. You untied Raimi, who rushed him, and then Carl is also rushing him.
But we always
that's what's happening right
now. I have my hand raised as high five.
Yeah. We always act weird. Isn't that like, that's our MO?
Okay, whether or not you're attacking him, we're still in combat, or at least I'm going to treat it as combat, because shit's about to get technical about what exactly happens and when.
Technical.
Sure.
I got a... Ah, damn, I got 6. I was almost part of the 7.
Nope, nope you're not
can we get the nat 1 for this cool 7s party roll bonus? Shit.
7s across the board.
Yeah, I think that's a
Hey guys, 6 is right.
This guy's not even the real 7.
It's almost not 6. Like us. It's almost 7.
7 or bust.
Oh.
You're bust.
You're pretty busty.
Huh?
We're good now?
We're good. I think everyone's... this roll?
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. That's all of us. All
right.
Go ahead and
tell
push
your roommate to shut the fuck up.
Push our shit in. Mr. Glowy Godman.
All right. The king sees...
Seizes up. Like, he has a seizure.
almost in slow motion. Quick, like, he kind of sees what's happening. You know, that he sees the ropes fall off Raimi and her just darting for him. And he grabs towards an amulet around his neck.
That's not good.
And
he's clutching his pearls.
This is Jedwin. You can feel an intense psychic energy coming off of this.
Pearls.
And a metallic hand punches through the floor in front of him.
Holy
shit.
Whoa.
I retract my statements and I walk away. I quit the druid circle and I go live to be a hermit somewhere on Poor Person Island.
And pulling itself up is what appears to be, well, if Carl Seven did robo steroids.
Oh, fuck.
Great.
I am no. Carl One.
Patterned on this. Actually, you don't even need to see it. Carl knows exactly what this is. This is the prototype.
Oh, fuck.
All right, my eyes turned red.
What the hell is that?
So that
Carl version 2.177
in front of.
Do yes, you even lift, bro?
Alpha Carl. This is Raimi is rushing towards, and then it pulls itself up in front of her.
Come on, Raimi, don't be a bitch.
Four knights also rush into the room from either side because they've been summoned.
It took them four knights to get there.
So are we dead? Is this what's happening?
From that joke, probably.
I feel like we're gonna be okay.
Yeah,
we're gonna be all right.
Who do, is it? Jedwin's turn. Jedwin shoots his Eldritch Blast at the king's necklace.
Just ignore that.
Okay. It's not Jedwin's turn yet.
Jedwin's gonna roll anyways.
Wait, I wrote down a 7, even though you got a 6. Like, apparently you turned me into that having a 7. Okay. It's actually Fumble's turn if he wants to do anything.
Oh, shit. I don't know.
Shoot some arrows at that king's necklace.
Technically, he does it... You don't know whether or not he regards you as hostile yet.
The king?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Raimi has escaped from her bondage. What happened?
What happened?
Next time.
Does he believe that?
Anybody else want to do anything?
I got a 17 to persuade him.
He's not even listening to you.
Yeah, I'm just
going to
wait.
He's focused on the undead that's rushing at him.
Just going to wait for my turn. We'll see what happens.
All right, so... All right, she rushes him. Just she's coming at him with bare hands because obviously you took her weapons away, and she runs like she gets there just as the Shield Guardian, which is what it's called, but it's a type of monster, but it's a prototype that he was working on. It's a living construct. Anyway, rolls it just as a Carl Zero has pulled himself out of the floor, so she runs smack into his giant shield that he's holding. He actually has a giant shield in one arm and a giant blade in the other. That's just cool. Imagine those, like,
Bareneek Knights from Dark
yes,
Souls.
That's another thing. There's a giant statue.
Those are my favorite to kill.
Are those the dudes in the...
The giant gold armor? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Not quite that huge. He's probably
The Bareneek Knights, like right outside the church when you first start playing, there's a guy in the black armor with the big giant mace. He's not as big as the gold guys, but he's still really massive.
Oh, okay.
He's a good 8 feet tall. He's a big papa.
I just noticed that the gold ones had the shield.
It's big daddy.
The black day. Black knights didn't have a shield.
Don't play shield. Corey, like, don't.
It's oh, he exact. Did have a shield. Yeah. I haven't played the game.
Yeah, you gotta roll behind him.
I'm forgetting
that. I actually just loaded it back up like did a week really? Ago. Yeah.
You playing with the keyboard this time?
Hell no.
Corey, we're not sadists.
Bitch.
We're all bitches. Well, you're just a sadist. You're the one that listened through all the ICB albums.
Oh, he's not done yet.
Not done yet.
Minutes?
Not done yet. Not done yet.
That was 30, I think. Or the 45. God.
By the time this is released,
55.
Oh, shit. All right, guys.
This will be our 3-hour episode.
So, yeah, Raimi rushes, and Carl Zero pulls itself up and kind of shield bashes her, and she stumbles backwards.
Ah, great.
I'm going to call that the end of the episode.
Fuck. Yay! Well, blind optimism that we're going to do great.
Yeah. You guys go chicken hunting.
Yeah. Wait. Woo. Who's going chicken hunting?
Who's going chicken hunting? Seriously, don't be a racist bigot around
or
ICP.
A woman.
Or gay.
Or gay.
Yeah.
Or Eminem.
Yay. Or Eminem.
Don't be Eminem.
Yeah, because they...
They're the worst. Yeah.
Or ICP. Don't be ICP. They're the worst.
Who was it? Wait, what was the analogy we said for ICP, like, calling out Eminem? Like, I forget what... We had a really good analogy for that. Juggalo like me can offer you just every time. Born Faygo down your mitts, we hand you the sweets of life. Juggalo will strip you down and fuck you in his face. Paint, chew off your panties and lick your pussy till you faint. I guess it's gonna be like if we tried to start a feud they're the with like Nerd Poker or something. Like that's the equivalent of that. It's like we don't even fucking exist to them. Like,
yeah.
It's like well, you're actually technically Nerd Poker doesn't exist anymore.
Well, we still don't exist to that. The other big one is a Critical Role, the one with all the voice actors on YouTube.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like if we try to start a feud with them, like we don't fucking calling exist you to out, them.
Critical Role. We got some beef and we ain't gonna squash it. Son.
We got some beef. We got some steaks and hamburgers. We're going to grill them up. You should come out and have a grill out with us. We know what you're up to,
Will Wheaton. Yes.
We're going to get The Rock on our podcast. The Rock's coming. Do you smell what Rory's cooking?
We're going to get
but for real
Vin
though,
Diesel if, and...
Yeah, if Vin Diesel comes to our podcast...
And
Sir, Damon The Rock Johnson. We'll do anything you want.
Matt Damon The Rock Johnson.
And Matt Damon... And Bill Affleck.
Thanks for listening.
And Nick Coppola.
Bill Cosby Affleck.
All those guys.
Patreon.
Listeners, join us as we delve deep into the archives and enjoy a preview of one of the first Daniel roles. Enjoy.
Testing interview mode microphone. Does this microphone recording sound good or does it sound bad? I'm about to find out when I listen to the thing I'm recording now. Thank you.
Hello and welcome to Daniel Roll, the internet's premier party roll podcast, appreciation and analysis podcast, in which I sit here in my appreciation hammock and I speak into my analysis microphone, which is in fact my mobile telephone. And in fact, that's my only recording equipment, and I'm using my dressing gown collar as a pop filter, because in all my test recordings, whenever I made a pee sound with my mouth and lips, the recording went all crazy and crackly and didn't sound very good. So anyway, yes, hello, my name is Daniel Kay. I'll be your host for this evening and every single subsequent evening which I decide to record my premiere party roll podcast, appreciation and analysis podcast on, and I hope you will join me in listening along to me when I'm listening after having finished recording. Now, at this stage, dear listeners, wherever you may be, relaxing at home, in bed, or at work, perhaps driving from home to work, having relaxed, and then finished relaxing, and then gone to work, you may be asking yourself, who is this person who speaks to me? Who is Daniel Kay? Why is he making a podcast? What podcasting experience? No, you wouldn't be asking that. No human being would ask that. In this situation, I'm going to start again, starting in 3, 2. At this stage, beloved listeners, all right, I'll just come right out and say what I wanted to say. I don't have any experience recording my voice or recording anything for that matter, or I don't even have experience speaking into a microphone. I've never broadcasted. I've never been on any kind of radio, professional or amateur. I've never made a podcast before, so you may have noticed This one's really quite slapdash and hodgepodge and not a perfect professional podcast. But you know what? I'm trying my best and I hope you like it, even if it is imperfect. Yeah, because I wouldn't want you to dislike it. That's a pretty good reason. I have to unlock my phone screen every single time I want to finish a take. I'm doing this in little bite-sized bits, like 30 seconds of recording at a time, and then I'm finishing, hitting stop, and then sort of thinking of what to do next. And I figure at some stage in the future, I'll take all these bites and I'll cut them all together to make it snappy and entertaining, and maybe like a highlights reel. It'll sort of come out as being exciting and I'll be well-spoken. But right now, no, I'm a stumbly moron who doesn't know what he's doing. But I digress. What I was saying is that every single time I finish my little one-minute recording and go to hit the stop button, my phone screen locks. I have to draw my secret pattern, my theft-proof phone pattern thing, to get to the menu where the stop thing is. So there's always this awkward moment at the end of every single recording where I go, "Ooh, I forgot." And you can hear the sort of stupid squeak of my thumb dragging across my screen, my slightly cracked screen. Okay, now that I've put the finishing polishing... Oh, fuck it. Okay, now that I've put the poli... The fu- Okay, now that the introduction is all done with, I'm going to finish up for today and listen to the first episode, the very first episode of the Party Roll podcast, which is titled Party Roll -1 -previously on Party Roll ... And then I'm going to pick up my phone and start recording this podcast again. And by then, hopefully, I will have really penned out all the topics I want to cover in my discussion, my analysis, my appreciation of the Party Roll podcast. So it'll be really great, really structured. It'll be like a fun little sort of exam, a little paper on the podcast. Maybe it'll be more fun than that horrible, nightmarish thing which I just said. Yeah, this one wasn't any better than take one. So whatever, you get what you get. Fuck you all. Goodbye. I mean, stay tuned. I'm about to start talking again.